All right, Facebook crowd, Levi back again for another lick of the week. This week's lick is influenced by players like Robin Ford and Frank Gambale. You could think of it as a cross between those two sort of sounds. It's going to take traditional blues phrasing and then include a bit of economy picking or sweet picking, depending on what you like to describe it as. So you're going to want to take this one pretty slowly. So as usual, like and share this video. And when we reach our usual limit, we will share the tab for you right away. So let's take a look at the lick. Okay, so this lick outlines a D minor chord. And you can think of it as fitting around the minor pentatonic scale position 1. The first lick is unashamedly stolen from Robin Ford. I really like this little idea, and it involves sliding up to the 10th fret on the B string, playing the 10th fret on the high E, then 13 on the E, but then playing 13 on the B and bending up a tone to the D. If have to excuse my pitching a little bit because these strings are nines. Anyone that knows what strings they like to play, they'll know that if you change to another gauge, it feels a little bit weird and your bending is usually out, and I'm a tens man. So what we have, if I isolate just that part nice and slow, would be. Some people struggle with that rolling from the high E string to the B string. Think of it more as you're fretting the B string, because that's where the bend is going to be executed. Like that. But you're just, from that position, you can move over, you can roll the finger down and play that high E string. What you don't want to do is play that high E string like you'd be playing the high E string, and then suddenly have to roll over onto the B string and try and bend like that, because you're probably going to detach your fingernail doing that. So, first part of the lick. Okay, so from there, classic Jimmy Pageism, 10 on the high E, 13 on the B, pull off to 10, and then 12, bend, 10, 10 on the B and high E. So, my mistake, though, I actually add in the 13th fret on the B string as well, so the thing that I'm really thinking about is the note that I'm targeting for a bit of colour. So those of you that know my approach to playing, I always reference the pentatonic scale and then talk about adding colour tones to that. And in this case, I'm going to be adding the 9th as a colour tone, so the minor pentatonic scale. If I add the 9th to that, it adds a little bit of colour and reminds me of players like Eric Johnson and Joe Bonamassa. So I'm really targeting this 12th fret note. So if I play the lick and then move back up, you'll notice that when I play this note, look for when I hit the fret with the double dots on, it instantly sounds, oh wow, that's a little bit sweet. Okay, so slowly. Okay. And those of you that saw my second lick of the week, you saw that I taught an Eric Johnson style fives descending pattern. I steal the top two string set of that, which would be 13, 10, 13, 10, 12, which I play down, up, down, up, up. And then I repeat that fragment, but starting on the B string. Okay? So everything so far has kind of been a blend of Robin Ford and Eric Johnson, or Joe Bonamassa. If I play that slowly up to this point. Okay, so it's got that D minor sound. I'm a big advocate of economy picking and a big fan of Frank Gambale, and this is an economy picking phrase which I use often to change positions, and it involves going 10, 12, 14, 13 on the B string, 12 on the high E, and then 15 on the high E. So we have... Now, if you look at the picking for that, I'm going down, up, down, 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 up. So there's a sweep across the strings. So from there, we would move down 13, 12, 15 on the B, and then 14 on the G. So there's a lot of moving across strings here. You don't really hear phrasing like that in traditional blues players, so you could think of this as a bit of a fusion blues lick. Then we would just move up 13, 15, 13, 15 on the B and high E strings, and then that 15th fret would be bent up a tone. So if I just play that second fragment slowly for you, then I'll glue the two together. Okay, and then the two played together would be... To finish the lick, you know, to take it somewhere, to resolve it, I play a bit of a Stevie Ray theft of a lick, and it sounds like this. Okay, and that would be 15 on the B, which I play twice, 13, 15, bend 15 up to 17, and then bend 13 with the first finger up to 15, which is a bit of a monster on the finger, but can be done because, as I said, I usually play tens and I can pull that off. If that doesn't work for you, what you could do is bend the 14th fret up a semitone and you'll get the same sort of effect. Okay, and then we finish the lick with 13, 15 on the B, 13 on the high E, and 15. And sometimes I'll hit, just to finish it, 13th fret on the high E with a little bend, okay? So that would be the entire lick, very long. I know, as I always say, you'll want the tab for these to reference these. I'll play it a little bit slower for you, and then kind of a little bit faster. So here it is slowly. Faster. I really hope you enjoyed that lick. You'll definitely want to check out players like Robin Ford, Scott Henderson, Frank Gambale, Eric Johnson, Joe Bonamassa, if you like that sort of thing, and you can melt all of their styles together and create your own unique style. Like and share this video. As I always say, what I would really like to emphasise on this one is I would love to see a video of you playing this one. So please do post a comment underneath this video with a video of you playing it, because we'd love to watch it in the office. So until next week, I'll see you soon.